With our heroes seemingly having the upper hand on both Goku Black and Zamasu, we bear witness to Vegeta being able to beat down Black into the dirt while Goku holds off Zamasu, but even with that, something devastating and more destructive is on the horizon as we bear witness for the first time ever, the merger between Zamasu and Goku Black. What's going on, Dragon Ball fans? Welcome to my Dragon Ball Super Episode 64 breakdown review leading into Dragon Ball Super Episode 65 entitled Revere Him, Praise Him, Fusion Zamasu, Explosive Birth, leading into Dragon Ball Super Episode 65, and what will be the ultimate showdown. Now keep in mind, guys, this video will contain massive amounts of spoilers, so in case you guys don't want this episode ruined for you, simply fast forward the video, go watch the episode, and come back so we can talk more Dragon Ball Super. This episode, I will say, was fantastic from start to finish. The build-up leading into this fusion, of course, was tremendously well executed, and of course, with the animation and the tension building up, things are starting to look very grim. Just as we all thought that Goku and Vegeta just had the upper hand, we saw the ultimate birth of this new merger occur. Now again, guys, if you guys want to go on ahead and take a second to also like the video and show your support, that would really mean a lot to me, and make sure to follow me at Twitter at UnrealENTGaming so we can talk more Dragon Ball latest stuff on there as well. So this episode, guys, let's get right into the nitgrits of this episode. Now looking at the official subtext on crunchyroll.com and stuff, we actually get to see how this all came about, and we also get to see a few new things and details that we really haven't seen from Goku Black or Zamasu yet, especially with the weapon that Black was wielding and of course the techniques that he was using against Goku and Vegeta. So even following this episode, the episode preview suggests and tells us firsthand that the fusion and the merger between Zamasu and Goku Black is not going to be taken lightly, because we see how the ultimate fusion begins to push everyone back, even creating somewhat of a halo behind him, in which case we do see in the episode preview how Goku and Vegeta and even Trunks are all charging this fusion at the same time, and despite what they do, despite all of their attacks, even despite the Mafuba, this fusion manages to beat everyone down so bad that we get to see Vegeta struggling to get up, we get to see Goku who's also struggling to get up, we see how Trunks is trying to cut him in half, guerrilla warfare style, we have 3v1, and we ultimately see how this fusion is so strong that it's able to push everyone back. So we start the episode off, and mind you, the music in this entire episode was perfect from start to finish, so if you guys are looking to watch an episode with really, really good music in it, this would be the episode to do so. But even with that, we see how right during the early beginning, we notice how Goku Black is fighting Vegeta, and Goku Black doesn't seem to be, you know, at all concerned, because in the beginning he was laughing until Vegeta put the beats on him, and then even after Vegeta put the beats on him, in which case he threw him through buildings, he was punching him through the ground again, we see how Goku Black pretty much tells Vegeta that having to use and utilize the spirit of anger to get stronger is pretty much disgusting. So Goku Black is insulting Vegeta, and he's telling Vegeta that he feels as if it's very insulting and disrespectful and disgusting that Vegeta gets stronger due to the nature of anger, when in fact it's kind of contradictory, because Goku Black himself gets stronger through pain. So we see how Goku Black is taking all of Vegeta's shots, and of course there was even a certain moment in which case he unleashed his little blade that he had, the energy sword that he had within his arm, and he pretty much stabbed himself, and Vegeta was watching him as to what he was doing, and we see how we notice that Goku Black pulls out this scythe, this Grim Reaper like scythe out of his hand, and that's when Vegeta stumbles across the weapon as he notices it, and he says, "What's that?" And Goku Black tries to attack him, or at least we all presume that it's going to be an attack, but instead what Goku Black did was he unleashed and created a giant time rift, somewhat of a hole in the sky, and this hole in the sky actually reminded me a lot of the Xenoverse 2 time rifts that we saw in the quests and whatnot. But needless to say, we see how Vegeta notices that, and he says, "What is that?" And Goku Black responds by saying, "I don't know, it could be another universe, it could be something to where it's connected to the past, it's connected to the future, I don't know what that is, but you'll soon to find out." So Vegeta is looking upon this hole in the sky, and nobody knows what it is. We notice how Zamasu notices that, and he begins to laugh as he's confronted by Goku, in which case Goku says, "You're too confident in your immortality, so you leave yourself open to attack," and he says something similar to that as he said to Frieza, but Zamasu looks at Goku and he says, "You know, I don't really care, you're in no position to be barking orders at me, I am a god, and you are beneath me, mortal," and just as he said that, we saw how Goku was unleashing some attacks on him. So despite what Goku does, and in which case we saw how intense their fight was, we notice how Mai and Trunks are trying to talk to Bulma about the Mafuba jar, and Zamasu is in a way trying to pursue Trunks, Bulma and Mai, but Goku stands in the way. But we also notice how, you know, Goku and Zamasu begin to battle throughout the city, and we notice how, you know, buildings are starting to fall down. We notice how Goku and Zamasu are going through buildings and stuff. Everything's beginning to crumble, and at a certain point, we also notice how Bulma begins to panic, that knowing the fact that, you know, Goku is kind of getting pushed back a little bit, and the fact that she asks Mai, how is it going with Goku, Vegeta's Black, and Zamasu, and Mai tells Bulma that Zamasu is heading right for them, and that's when Bulma begins to panic. And that bunker was like right smack dab in the middle of the city, I would say, right in front of like Capsule Corp in essence. It's really not that hard to miss, so that's why Zamasu wanted to pursue them and kill them, obviously enough being public enemy number one. But we notice how Bulma actually suggests to Trunks to use the Mafuba on Zamasu, but you know, Trunks doesn't really know what the Mafuba is. He doesn't know what his mom is talking about. So that's when we see Bulma pretty much pull out her phone, and she has a recording of Piccolo using a technique to where he's sealing off some energy in the Mafuba jar. So and it's really weird to see that, because we all wish that Piccolo was in the situation to pretty much explain to everyone how it went down. But needless to say, we notice how Trunks is trying to learn the Mafuba while Zamasu is in pursuit to try to kill them off, and Bulma tells Trunks that she'll buy some time while he tries to learn the Mafuba with Mai. But even with that, we see how Goku Black keeps bragging about his divine techniques and his divine power, and we see how Goku emerges from the rubble, and him and Vegeta are standing there. But we also notice that there are various different versions of Goku Black all around the area, very similar to Metal Cooler in that movie. I don't know if you guys remember that, but when Metal Cooler was able to pretty much replicate himself due to the Big Yeti Star, and we had tens of thousands of Metal Coolers, that was the exact same thing that happened here, except that every single time Goku and Vegeta would punch them off or do something, they would fade away, but then more of them would come through the rift. So we see how more of them are coming through the rift, and they're fighting Goku and Vegeta off, and we see how, obviously enough, Goku Black is in the middle. He is the head leader, and he begins to taunt Goku and Vegeta and saying that they won't be able to chase after Zamasu, especially knowing the fact that there are multiple Goku Blacks standing in their way. So we see how Goku and Vegeta are trying to like punch them off, kick them off, but nothing is working here, and every single time Goku Black attacks, or at least the clones, they do significant damage. So we notice how Black says Zamasu had already probably killed your friends by now, it's useless to resist. And we notice how, you know, Black pretty much says to both Goku and Vegeta, maybe your anger over your failure to protect the ones you love will make you stronger still, right boys? Go on ahead, get stronger. So he's taunting them both while he's, you know, overseeing his clones beat up Goku and Vegeta, and Vegeta suggests for Goku to use instant transmission to get to Trunks quick enough before Zamasu gets there, but Goku says that he can't do it because something within that time rift is able to distort his senses. So Goku wasn't able to use the instant transmission because causing that time rift to affect him really affected him in a bad way. So Bulma pretty much goes outside and she begins to flirt with Zamasu. Now, one little problem that I had here was the fact that if Zamasu really did hate mortals the way he did, logically speaking, if you don't want to take any chances, if anybody was really him, they would have killed off Bulma right then and there. And we notice how Trunks has like this PTSD going on, because he walks outside and he sees his mother being, you know, choked to death. We see how Zamasu had her by the shirt, and it looked very, very similar to when you know, future Bulma got killed off by Goku Black right in the beginning of this arc. So Trunks loses his freaking mind. It was so cool to see. But of course, Trunks didn't really pop off that bad, because as Zamasu threw Bulma away, he says, what are you gonna do? And Trunks says, you know what I'm gonna do? This is what I'm gonna do. So he unleashes the Mafuba, and in which case, I know a lot of you guys are gonna start talking some shit, because a lot of you guys are gonna be like, well, how the hell did Trunks learn the Mafuba so quick? Like, is this like a pass going on thing? Like, it's like you're passing on moves like easily now. So it's at this point, anyone in the show can learn anything. So we notice how, you know, Trunks uses the Mafuba, and he pretty much, you know, uses Mai's assistance to seal Zamasu away. So Zamasu was finally sealed away, but Bulma said, we have to, you know, permanently put the magic sticker on to permanently keep him from, you know, breaking out. But of course, they didn't really have the magic sticker because it was left at Roshi's house. So they forgot the sticker at Roshi's house. And of course, they can't really go back in time now because of the situation with Zamasu having to burst out of the Mafuba jar. We notice how, you know, Black notices that there's something wrong with Zamasu's key. He quickly goes to him and he asks him, like, what happened? And that's when Zamasu says, these mortals aren't just bugs like we assume they are. We're going to have to take necessary precautions in order for us to complete our plan. We can't take them lightly anymore. And that's when we see Goku Black and Zamasu standing over Gowasu, Supreme Kai, Goku, Vegeta, Trunks, Mai, and Bulma. And that's when Zamasu takes off his earring. He puts it on the right side of his ear. And that's when we bear witness to the ultimate fusion. And right from the start, once Zamasu took off his earring, he started dangling it in front of the Supreme Kai and Gohwasu and everyone. And then Goku and Vegeta noticed right away, because at some point they managed to fuse themselves. And right then and there, we see them fuse. So once they fuse, Goku and Vegeta realize right from the start that this is going to spell big trouble for everybody, because of the fact that they know firsthand how dangerous this can actually be. And we see the birth of this new Zamasu God, and we notice how obviously enough, we already know that Mozawa wasn't going to record her voice to be alongside Zamasu, so Zamasu's fusion does not have a dual voice, it's actually just Zamasu. So we see how he begins to speak, and he pretty much, you know, opens up his eyes, and we cut off to the preview. I know a lot of you guys are going to be really upset on the fact that we didn't really get to see more, but I've noticed that the animation was relatively good, the music was spot on, and the overall storytelling aspect, as I said last week, you know, Vegeta at this point, you know, had the powers to kind of defeat him or at least push him back. But we also noticed how, in a way, it didn't really do as much damage as we all thought it would, because in a nutshell, despite what Vegeta was doing, Black was still alive, and he was kind of making fun of Vegeta, saying, well, if that's all the power you have, then I pity you, because, you know, in an essence, you rely on anger to get stronger, whereas opposed to I rely on pain. So it's really weird the way they went about that, but either way, it makes Zamasu out to, well, at least Goku Black out to be a hypocrite, because Black also relies on something similar to Vegeta as a way to grow, get stronger. So the entire episode, I would have to say, was very solid. I love the way the earrings pretty much lit up towards the very end as we saw them fuse. Another thing that I really loved was the fact that, you know, Black was able to create this little, you know, opening in the sky, but it really wasn't, you know, explained upon as to what it was. As Goku Black even said it himself, he was like, I don't really know what it is. It could be, you know, a different universe, it could be a different timeline, it could be the past, it could be the present, the future, who knows. But even through that little hole in the sky, we notice how we saw a bunch of Goku Blacks emerge. So whatever technique that is, it's a very innovative technique and a very useful technique, because it was able to ultimately enough push Goku and Vegeta back a little bit from doing anything. Like, these dudes weren't able to do anything. And towards the very end, guys, we see the fusion happen. Now, in the episode preview, we get to see how the fusion of Zamasu and Goku Black caused, like, some sort of, like, a halo behind him or something. Whatever it is, it was actually very, very cool looking. And in an essence, it reminded me a little bit of Whis and Vados' logo that they have behind them or above their heads and whatnot. So somewhat like a halo in a way. But in this case, they would not need a halo, because everything they're doing right now just disembodies them from being an angel in that regard. But either way, we see this giant white circle behind them. So maybe it's something of use, maybe it's like a just a simple prop, we don't know. But we see how he was able to pretty much level the entire city, and we see how Goku, Vegeta, they're all struggling to get up. And it's a very dire situation. It's a very, very, very dire situation, because how else are they supposed to defeat this guy, especially now Zamasu knowing that the Mafuba is something that can actually destroy him, or at least put him away. But the downside to this is the fact that they don't have the sticker. So it's like, what do? They're in a situation now where they have to get that sticker, but the sticker is at Master Roshi's house. So it's like, what the heck do they do? Do they go get the sticker? It's like, are they gonna time travel again? Which I really doubt that's gonna be the case, but either way, you have to ask yourself, it's like, what do they do now? In a situation to where, you know, it's life or death, like during this cause, given the fact that the fusion is there, it's like, what do? So we see how everyone is struggling, and we see how I think that Trunks pretty much has the upper hand going into next week's episode in a way. I think he's gonna fare off a little better than Goku and Vegeta are, but I want to know your thoughts down below, because I put out my just, you know, brief review, and a lot of you guys seem to love the concept. However, a lot of you guys were also a little upset on the fact that Trunks was able to learn the Mafuba so quick, and I saw how some of you guys feel as if it's really unfair, you know, to have that happen, because normally enough, it takes a long time for people to learn moves and whatnot, but now in the show, it looks like Trunks has learned everything. Trunks knows the Mafuba, Trunks knows the Galaga Gun, Trunks knows the Final Flash, so it's like, and he also knows the Masenko, so he knows four moves now. He knows the Masenko, Final Flash, Galaga Gun, and the Mafuba. So Trunks, if anything, stands as Zamasu's greatest threat, because with the sheer power that he has with him, it's like, how can Trunks not be stopped? But easily enough, I mean, Zamasu wanted to destroy them, and I think that was a missed opportunity in an essence, because we saw how Zamasu was there in front of Bulma, but there was no need for him just to grab her by the throat and just hold her there, especially if he truly, truly despises humans as much much as he says he does, you know, there was no reason for him just to fool around. If he really wanted to destroy Bulma and Trunks and Mai, I think he could have done it. But for storyline purposes, we need Bulma alive. But let me know your thoughts down below, guys. What are your overall thoughts as to all of the events that have transpired so far in this episode, guys? Let me know your thoughts. Also, keep in mind, I'll be doing the prediction video right now. So in case you guys want to hear my thoughts on what's going to happen next week, simply comment down below. Let me know and tune in for the predictions video, guys. And also, the live stream is happening tonight where we're all going to get together and talk some Dragon Ball Super, guys. So let me know your thoughts. Thank you all for watching. As always, if you guys are fans, don't forget to subscribe for more awesome daily Dragon Ball videos. If you guys cannot wait for next week's episode, punch that like button square in the face, guys. Let me know your thoughts. Tune in for the next video update, and I'll be seeing you all in the comment section below. Take it easy, guys. Peace.